I do want to share, perhaps this would be a good thing to close on. You were thinking about, you know, all the problems with scripture. It made me think about a poem. It's the only poem I cited any length in the book. It's by Yehuda Amichai. And he was thinking the way that, you know, whether it was Luther who wanted to edit scripture and get at some of the stuff he didn't like, which actually was a much older argument in Christian thought about whether Hebrew Bible should even be scripture at all. And, you know, and which parts and how do you think about the First Testament. And that we now edit the Bible often subconsciously. We just forget certain parts. Or we just don't, you know, when, so in many synagogues, you'll study by the weekly Torah portion and it moves all the way through the calendar year. And there are people just stop showing up when you get to Leviticus. You can just pretend it's not there.
Right.
But Yehuda Amichai writes this poem where he tried to edit scripture, right? Tried to make it a better good book. And this is his poem. I filtered out of the book of Esther the residue of vulgar joy, and out of the book of Jeremiah the howl of pain in the guts, and out of the Song of Songs the endless search for love, and out of the book of Genesis the dreams and Cain, and out of Ecclesiastes the despair, and out of the book of Job. and from what was left over, I pasted for myself a new Bible. And now I live, censored, and pasted, and limited, and in peace. So he basically took out that everything that is intellectually suspect, emotionally difficult, and he's left with something that doesn't speak to the wholeness of the human experience. What is compelling about our texts is that they do dig into the light and into the dark of the human story. And I think we need them to help us do that. And if we can do it with a self-critical lens, then they'll do their most sacred work.
That's beautiful. And what a way to close. I love that poem. I need to print that out, have that on my wall. That's beautiful. It's very funny, too.
It is. I actually had the privilege of studying with him for a semester when my first year in rabbinical school.
Oh.
There's just so much expertise in Jewish thought in Israel. The first year of study was in Israel. So you have all of these world-class scholars, you know, amazing. Sometimes you know, needing an extra gig. So he taught at the seminary as an adjunct, even though he was this world-class poet. And so I can read it with his voice in my head.
Hey, thank you so much for checking out this video clip from the Dogato podcast. To get more videos like this, simply subscribe here on YouTube. You can also download the full episode of each show on iTunes, Spotify, Google Play, or your favorite podcast player. Take care.